Hi, in this video, I want to talk about the photo match feature in Google SketchUp. And I'm using version 8 of Google SketchUp. So let's go to File, Import, and I have a building here that I want to use as a new match photo. You should get this dialog box, the match photo dialog box. If you don't, you can go under Camera, Edit Match Photo, Building Front Photo Match, because that's the name of my image file. And I have the spacing of the grid set at 1 foot, and I may just change it to 5 feet for now to make it a little easier to see everything. Now, Photo Match works best if you have something like a two-point perspective image, and that's what I have with this image. All these lines here converge to some vanishing point out here. All these lines on this side of the building go to some vanishing point out here. So I just need to take these perspective lines and line them up with lines on the building. So I just left click and move it close to where I want, zoom in, and I say, well, I'm going to put it on the bottom course, that black right there, and I'm going to stretch it and put it right there. So that's one perspective line going to the vanishing point. Grab another one. I'm going to put it on the corner of the building because that should all be on the same elevation. Right about there. And let's say this corner right here. That should be the same. So now I've got my grid pointing to this vanishing point. I'm going to go to the green side. Pick a line. That's that. And I'm going to drag down this one and put it on the corner of the white. And the other corner, and you can see that I have it pointing to the other vanishing point. So all these lines should converge down to this vanishing point, and all these lines on this side of the building should converge way out to this vanishing point. The yellow line is the horizon line that goes between the vanishing points, and this is the origin. I'm going to just drag it to the center of the building. And you can see I'm pretty close to having my vertical line right on the corner of the building. It's not bad, but if you want to get more accurate, you can just sort of move these around a little bit. And now I'm on the corner of the building. And I can go back to my match photo, and I can go done. Well, I'm not really done, because if you look at this young lady, she's huge. So I don't have the scale set very well on this project. So I'm going to go back to my match photo, and I'm going to change the scale to 1 foot. And that brings up a 1 foot grid. And I'm going to estimate that the door is about 7 feet tall. Now, I don't know if that's true, but I'm going to estimate so I can get a decent scale for this building. To change the scale, you can see if I go on the red line or the green line, it gets two little arrows, and you can zoom in and out. By going to the left, it's making the scale smaller. Going to the right, bigger. So if I go to the left and I look at my grid, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Well, I got to go a little bit more. I'm going to say right there. So if I zoom in, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Zoom out a little bit, 7. So I said the door is 7 feet high. I have a pretty good scale for the building now. And I can go done. The other thing, in version 8, you can see she's a little bit transparent. So if I go to Window, Styles, and I go to Edit, and to this blue model settings, you can see the match photo, foreground photo. If I click that off, she becomes fully opaque, and I click on it, I can change the transparency of this young lady. And what's the point of that? Well, if you wanted to draw a surface, so I have a surface on here, and maybe you want to have it so it's kind of transparent so you can draw and see how the building actually looks, and later on you want it to be solid. So the other thing about this, let's say I'm going to make it solid right now, get rid of my styles. If I draw a surface and I click on the surface and I can project the textures from the photo, well, I'm going to reverse the face first so I get the outside face out. I can project textures from photos. And if you look at it, and I can go back to Windows, Styles, I can turn off the background photo. I projected the building onto my surface, so I have a piece of it, the bricks. Well, I'll show you a little bit more about how this works. Let's delete that, turn on the background photo, and I'm going to click this off so the foreground is completely opaque. All right, what can we do with Photo Match? Well, first thing you can do is you can build a building really quickly. So let's say you need a background building. Let's see here. Background building. Just putting a surface on. I'm going to reverse it. Maybe I'm going to drag it out a little bit on the red line. And I'm going to drag it to the back of the building. So now I've got a 3D object that I can work on. If I go back to the photo match, I can select everything and project it, and I've got a building. And if I wanted to clean it up, I probably would have cleaned up the image a little bit in Photoshop or the GIMP or something, got rid of stop signs, maybe got rid of the shadow, maybe got rid of the street light, because I wanted to make a building. And now I can just draw on it. Really quickly. And I can extrude it. And maybe I want to just put some asphalt on the top. Yep, let's grab the right one. Just to make it look black, and I'm not going to play with it too much. And maybe on the front, I want to clean this up a little bit. You can see why a good picture will really help you out, but really quickly, turn on some shadows. Really quickly, I have a building that I could use as a background in my model. And if I want to take this side here, I can go to Paint Bucket, hit the Alt key, use the eyedropper and select this side, paste it on that side. Maybe on the back, what I'll do is I'll just put on some bricks on the back because I don't have a picture of the back. And you can change the scale, whatever you want. But now I have a building. And if I was drawing a new skyscraper on the same street, I could show the client some kind of perspective of what's going to happen with his new building when I'm working on this one, and I have a 3D building. I can sort of show it from any angles. So that's really easy to do in Photo Match. Building a structure really quickly. So let's delete this and go back to my photo match. And let's build a surface again, but this time I'm only going to go about to here. And I'm going to drag it out. You got to be really careful you're drawing on the axis. You can see I got it on the red, and I'm going to hold the shift key so it continues on the red. It doesn't want to do it, but let's go to there. Reverse the face. And drag it to the back. Let's undo it. I didn't grab it all the way. Select it. Project textures from photos. Now I've got the bottom part of the building projected, and what I can do is I can group it. When you look at it, I have the bottom part of the building. And what I can do now is I can draw another top on it, and I can say, let's go up 40 feet and let's put on some siding. And let's put on some windows. Let's see here, I'm going to put a window with some translucent material. I got to pick it first. And I'm just going to use the copy and the array. And copy. And what I've done is I've just quickly added on a new piece to the building. And if my photo was bigger, that's why you'd like to have a big photo. And maybe I'll get rid of this shadow on the ground. I can show the client a what-if scenario of how I can put on a new four-story addition to their building. And you can sort of see, too, that it's 3D, so I can work on this addition and make it a little better. Just paint that side. And so you can do what-if scenarios with PhotoMatch. And then I can show, well, I had this building, I just made it bigger, and then I have my new skyscraper on the street that I'm building too. So you can do all sorts of things with PhotoMatch that can help you out and show the client your changes, your improvements, or your new concept. So give PhotoMatch a try.